HS2 is Britain's brand new high-speed railway, connecting London with the Midlands. It's the first major intercity link north of the capital in over 100 years, and it's going to transform the way we travel. Hi, I'm Clive. I'm Senior Project Manager for Strabag, Costain Skanska Joint Venture, working on HS2's London Tunnels contract. For the last 3 years, our teams have been building something pretty special here in London Borough of Hillingdon. It's called the Copthall Green Tunnel.
The tunnel runs 880 metres between Harvil Road in the west and Breakspear Road south in the east. It sits between two major features of the HS2 route, the Northolt Tunnel and the Colne Valley Viaduct. Copthall is one of 5 green tunnels being built along the HS2 route. These are shallow, cut and cover tunnels designed to blend into the landscape. Once they're done, it'll be topped with trees, shrubs and grasses, creating a green corridor right through the part of West London. We've just completed the base slab and the roof slab, huge milestones for the team. That marks over 3 years of steady progress since work began in December 2021. All 5 of the tunnel's 15-metre ventilation shafts are now complete too, with the final concrete pour happening just recently. At the east portal, we've started installing props, whalers. Over the western end, the steel frame for the tunnel's headhouse is in place and the roof is underway. We're also building the walkway walls inside the tunnel, and overall, we're about 90% of the way through the physical completion of the tunnel. With the main tunnelling nearly done, we're moving into the fit-out stage. That means getting everything ready for the railway, track installation systems, and safety infrastructure. Next up is the noise barriers. The noise barriers are 1 kilometre of precast panels to keep the train noise within the existing limits, similar to the nearby Chiltern railway line. After successful testing, we begin the main works in June. That includes more than 400 piles, 500 precast panels, some as high as 5.5 metres.
We're committed to building sustainably. A lot of the material we excavate gets used right here on site, shaping the landscape and reducing the number of lorries on the local road network. It has helped us to create over 40 hectares of new habitat, what we call the sustainable placement areas. To the north of the tunnel, we've formed 4 large mounds using circa 647,000 cubic metres of excavated material. And we're just finishing up the planting of over 45,000 trees, plants and shrubs. And we've already seen the wildlife returning. In the southern sustainable placement area, we have 3 mounds that have been created from the spoil from the Northolt Tunnel's west. Seeding and planting is progressing well, and we're expected to finish the seeding works by the end of April this year. By next spring, we will have planted over 70,000 different trees, plants and shrubs across both sites, including 60 different species like English oak and sweet chestnut.
We're currently stood on West Ruislip retained embankment with Gatemead embankment behind us. Since your last visit, we've completed the bulk earthworks in both areas, and looking forward, we're going to be completing the landscaping and the permanent drainage.
One of the big things we did recently was a realignment of the River Pinn. It used to be a very straight and square channel built about 100 years ago for the Chiltern Lines railway bridge. We made it more natural with curves and different depths so the water flows better. This helps the river be healthier for plants and animals. We've added plants that live in water and even put in a fallen tree to give fish places to hide when the water is flowing fast. We're also making the footpaths along the river safer and easier to use for everyone. You can see the green walls we've built to support the new footpath using natural plant-filled blocks in a system called rootlock. It's wonderful to see the wildflower and grass growing now that spring is here, and we've even spotted lots of birds and fish enjoying their new home. Next, we'll be putting in a new footbridge so people can easily cross the river, and we'll be taking away the temporary elements we've used to build everything here. Then we'll connect up the drainage, landscape the area to make it a beautiful green space that everyone can enjoy for many years to come.
The Copthall Tunnel is just one part of a much bigger picture. With Old Oak Common Station already taking shape, HS2 is bringing new investment, housing, jobs and regeneration to West London. This is more than just a railway. It's about building a greener, better connected future and laying the foundations for the next generation of rail travel. Thanks for watching this update. We're proud of the progress that we've made on Copthall Tunnel, and there's plenty more to come.